Now we have a requested please the panelists onto on the stage the professor Thirachai Abhivatkakun Dr. Suvicha Sipadungkun and Dr. Chitsuvi Jiemton. And the first case we start with like the acute correction topic by the Dr. Pongsakorn.
Okay.
We have about the 20 minutes each case.
Okay, what we do is in these three cases, so it is now 11:30, let's say 35. We have 5 minutes because we start a little bit late, but it is still fine. We have another 55 minutes, almost 18 minutes per case. Let's say we will present to finish and then we have the panel to discuss, right? Ajahn Chitthavi, what do you think? Okay, let's start.
Good morning, moderator, co-moderator, and all panelists, and all audience in this room. I'm Dr. Pongsakorn from Rethin Hospital. Today, I will present the case discussion for the Mount Union. Thank you, Dr. Chitthavi, for planning for the operation in this case. Okay, our case is a 46-year-old male who present with deformity at left leg for 4 months after motorcycle accident. The first doctor after several operations, the first doctor advised him to amputate his left leg. So he came to our hospital for the second opinion. On the physical examination, show deformity and shortening of the left lower extremity around 4 centimeters. And there is an old surgical scar with poor quality of soft tissue on the anterior medial side. Pre-radiograph show malunion fracture of the left tibia with synostosis of the tibia to the fibula. The shortening of the left lower extremity is around 4 centimeters on auto-angiogram. We investigate the malalignment, and there's an external rotation of the left lower extremity around 20 degrees, valgus angulation around 5 degrees, and anterior angulation around 30 degrees. So the diagnosis in this case is a malunion of left tibia with shortening around 4 centimeters. And external rotation 20 degrees, valgus malalignment 5 degrees, and anterior apex angulation 30 degrees. So I would like to ask opinion from my panelists. What is your plan of management in this case?
Sorry that we cannot mention about a sagittal plane angulation in this session, but you can use this principle, and then please the panelists.
Doctor, should be me because it's your case. The first thing before decide to do anything, I need to check that it is a infection or not. Yeah, it must be clear that before correction and do anything. Is it infection? How about the blood profile? And maybe we need a bone scan to check is this infection?
Yeah, we mentioned about the infection also, and all investigations were negative. The ESR and CRP is in the normal range.
The other thing is the patient expectation. I see many patients is so boring for the multiple operation. There are many deformity in this case, but shortening is about 4 centimeters. Sometimes I ask patients, they accept about shortening about 2 centimeters and use the high heel shoe or something like that. If they accept the 2 centimeter shortening of this leg, I think acute correction with this case is possible. Sometimes I correct deformity like we don't need a truly osteotomy in this case because can you show the only the x-ray of the tibia? Only tibia. Please go to the previous slide. We don't truly need the osteotomy. We can remove the bone from the fibula osteotomy that remove the synostosis and acute correction and leave the gap about 2 centimeters. Because I put the plate inside, I think 2 centimeter gap is possible to heal to just only the bone grafting that we can harvest from the sum of the malunion and fibula and add the iliac crest graft. And we can leave the 2 centimeter shortening and with the high heel shoe. But if patient need don't want the shortening, 4 centimeter gap is possible for the muscular technique. You can osteotomy, put the plate inside and put the bone cement and perform the muscular later. And that is my opinion for this case.
Thank you.
In my opinion, the most important part is to analyze the deformities. First, but this case is obviously that the defect or the deformity is on the tibia. And usually we should list all the problem lists that we need to correct in this case. For example, how about the length? How about the axis in both coronal and sagittal plane? And how about the rotations? And as well as the associated soft tissue, we can see that there is a bone loss in the tibia, which we need later reconstruction. And when we look at the soft tissue, it's just maybe skin graft over the bone. We cannot do anything with these soft tissue conditions. If we can consider that we will regain the length at the initial state, but you will create the tension on the posterior part, like you may create any further equinus deformities from the Achilles. You will create the soft tissue problem in the anterior part, and you cannot do anything later. Another option is just shortening, make it union first, and you don't need maybe less area of the soft tissue coverage, and then you just lengthening it later. Or you can regain everything at the first operation, but you need a soft tissue coverage at that time to facilitate further bone reconstruction. So you can decide, you can do stage operations or you can do like a gradual correction with the hip support or something like that.
Chan Tam.
Yeah, life is very difficult for this case. There are multi-prana deformity and shortening. You see the malrotation of the tibia on the distal, and the proximal tibial fibula is also dislocation. So if I have this case, I think the ring fixator should be my option. It can be only one single instrument that can correct all. You can make the single plane distraction, but you cannot control the ankle. When you distract it, you will get the deformity, the equinus again. And this is really hard to do it later. So I think this is, maybe I consult my friend. Yeah, take the ring external fixator. This is the best option.
Yes. I think as Ajahn Thirachai said, you see, when you see these kind of things, you have to see where is the abnormality. The axis is multiplanar. You have and triangulation, you have a little bit varicose, and you have rotation. So length, axis, and rotation is wrong. Shortening as well, right? So many factors to correct. So that is, you know, you cannot do one time osteotomy and correct everything. When you have, let's say, 3 factors, I think, as he said, you have to use the ring and do gradual correction. But we have 2 kinds of ring. Even the ring that you can correct many things. If you use 1 point, if you have more than 2 or 3 parameters that you have to correct. Iliac roof conventional way, you have to change the hinge from this position and then change to another position, and then you have many operating time. So with this, it's a very indicated case for 2023 now. The hex support system, the only things that you can do. And this is very minimal invasive way, because you just do corticotomy at the angulation site, and then you do correction, and then you can do even length from another side by just putting the lengthening ring Elisarov attached, and then you can do it the other side. So you just only this, and then the bone defect. If you correct everything, you can put any kind of bone graft. Ajahn Chitthavi, what do you think if you have this kind of defect, we correct the deformity, or you have any option?
It depends on your plan when you discuss with the patients. As I mentioned, that we can just cross the defect initially, make it union. You have bone graft on from the fibula, just make it union, and we can just lengthening it later with maybe like a lengthening over the plate or the nail. I think, yeah.
Let's see.
Yeah. Thank you for the great comment. So I will explain my plan for manage in this case. So we decide for stage procedure. In the first stage, we plan to acute corrective osteotomy at the deformity site. And for the substitute, we plan for the flap coverage, for the good soft tissue coverage at the injury zone. And then we will do the bone lengthening over the plate fixation. Here is the picture that we plan for the operation. We will then do the acute corrective osteotomy and fix with the proximal tibia LCP and stabilize. Then we do the flap coverage and do the stage procedure for the lengthening over the plate at the medial, at the proximal tibia that we will transport for the ring that shortening around 4 centimeters. Intraoperatively, in the first operation, we done the acute corrective osteotomy. And thank you, Dr. Nawapung, for done the myocutaneous flap, a medial gastrocnemius mesh flap for me in this case. We excise the poor quality soft tissue on the anterior medial side, and done the corrective osteotomy and fix with the proximal tibial LCP. We use the chance screw to determine the rotation and correct the rotation also in this stage. So all parameter except the length is correct in this operation. Then we done the myocutaneous gastrocnemius flap coverage. Here is a post-operative, the first post-operative radiograph. The overall alignment is okay, is good, except the shortening of the left lower extremity. And we have the good soft tissue coverage at the deformity site. For the second operation, we wait for the flap has to be set around 2 or 3 weeks, and we done the external fixator. We use the hex support ring external fixator to lengthening of the tibia. We plan that upper copper ring is for lengthening, and the lower copper ring is used to stabilize the corrective site to promote the healing. And we remove all of the screw at the distal fragment to lengthen the proximal tibia. Here is the ring that we apply to our patient. Then we ask the patient to do the lengthening at the proximal part of the tibia, while the distal copper ring is used to stabilize the fracture and the corrective site to promote the healing. After we gain the proper rank, the equal rank of the lower extremity, we done the third operation that we fixed the transport segment and the distal segment. And here is the final post-operative radiograph. The alignment, all alignment was correct. And we can lengthening of the left lower extremity around 4 centimeters. And we wait for the consolidation of the new bone generation. Here is a clinical function after operation 1 year. The patient can walk without any gait aid and have the equal length. Sorry that I didn't bring the orthogonal angiogram to show you that all alignment was good. Thank you.
Thank you, and congratulations for a very success and patient is happy. One thing that I would like to comment is if you correct the angulation of the axis already and the only thing that you need is just length, right? So maybe just conventional ring is fine.
Yeah.
You don't need to have a hip support. But if, you know, there are many ways to treat the patient, and then maybe they use the conventional ring already in the hospital to correct another case, and they have only the hip support, that hip support you can use in any case. Yeah. That may be the reason, right?
Yes.
Yes. So the other sequence may be possible, as said, that you can even do with hip support only, and then converse to plate later. So there are many ways just to detect every problem and solve every problem at the same time. Okay, huh?
Thank you. So that was the first case.